This Monday, March 26th. Thought I'd run through a few of the NEOs that popped up over the weekend. We had a few pop up, and a couple of them are passing today rather close. If we look at the list right here, we can see that back on the 24th, we had FT35 pass at 1.9 liter distances. And we had FU23 on the 25th at 3.1. And we have two of them today, FP35 and FS35 at 0.4 and 0.2. These are rather small ones, one only about 10 meters, the other one only about 4 meters. And then we have the other one a little bit later on. It's going to be passing at 0.6. That's the larger one, about 60 meters. So we can take a look at a few of those on the screen here. And you can see this is FT35 when it's already passed. And we go over to the next one, and we have FU23. It's already passed also. And we have the ones that's passing today, FP35 here, and FS35 here. This is the one that's going to be the closest. It's also the smallest. And if you look at the distance down here, you can see that it's going to have two of them this year. We have one of them passing today, that distance there, and then on the September 2nd, 2012, it's also going to have a passage of 0.15. And then it goes to 2012 for the next one. But if you put that distance in the distance calculator, you get this distance here, which is 64,423. Or if you want to go the miles way, it'd be about 40,000 miles. And to get the most accurate on that, I knocked it down to a 6-hour time frame, used the horizon system. And we're using those numbers right down there for the closest one, the starry night. And the last one would be the one that we already knew about, EG5, which was the closest one up until yesterday. But you can go back and look at these, so you'll see that you don't have very many days here. Listen, here you have one day on there, and this one here we have 2 days, and on this one here another one day, just came out yesterday. And on this one here, it's basically the same thing. We had it was sighted on the 25th, and the solution came out on the 25th. So we can go ahead and look at those on the screen, and we'll get it going here, starting from the 24th, and we'll take and zoom in on it. And you can see FU23 exiting up this way, FS35 here, that's the close one. Here's the other close one over here. It's going to come up and pass the other one. We can take and zoom in a little bit more. And you can take and wiggle this around and make it look anything you want. This is a close one over here. You got a lot of 35s. So this right here is one that passes a 0.4, and this is one that passes a 0.2. And if you take and go back the other way, you can see it's going to be just about underneath the Earth when it makes its close approach. It'll be about 1700 today, universal time. And after that, it would be the ET5 again. Let me take and run that backwards. If you notice one thing, the sun's over here. both of these are coming from the dark side. If they were coming from the sunward side, you probably wouldn't have seen them until after they passed. That's the bad thing about small asteroids. They're extremely hard to pick up, and if they're coming at you from the sunward side, you're going to stand a lot harder chance of seeing them. That one's up above us by now. We go back over that way. Where is the sun? There is the sun. As you see, most of these came from the dark side. Alright, so I can run it ahead to the next one. And it will be the EG5. It should come in down here. And it's going to be passing at 0.6 lunar distances. There he goes. Alright, so I'll leave it at that and wait for the next few to pop up. Talk to you later.